One, and welcome to the Pembroke Board of Selectmen's meeting of Monday, January 9th, and we'll begin the meeting with a pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please note that this meeting is being made available to the public through a live video and audio broadcast on Comcast Government Access Channel 15, and is being recorded for broadcast at future dates. Comments made in open session will be recorded. First item on our agenda this evening is the transfer of a common victular license. And I believe we have Ashley Fall here with us tonight. Would you like to come up front, please? Ashley is part of the organization that's applying for this license. And she's here tonight to answer any questions that the board may have. May I say that this is a transfer of the common victualer's license to be exercised at 8 Main Street under the name of Vincent Venture, Inc., doing business as Bryantville Pizza Kitchen. And you're requesting to prepare and serve food to the public daily as is currently licensed from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. Sunday through Thursday and from 9 a.m. to 11 p.m. on Friday and Saturday. This application was not required to have a new building inspection as no structural or internal design changes were performed and no new permits were pulled. They were not required to have a hearing through the ZBA as there is no change of use. And the location will continue to operate as Bryantville Pizza Kitchen. And we have a letter from the ZBA attached to this application. You've got approved health inspection, food permits, and required certification through the Board of Health, and filed a business certificate with Town Clerk Mary Ann Smith. So after saying all that, would you like to address the board?
No. Sums it all up right there.
We've covered it all.
Yep.
Does the board have any questions?
I'll make a motion.
Fine.
I'd like to move that we grant the transfer of common victular license CV 52 to Ken Fall of Vincent Venture Incorporated, doing business at Bryantville Pizza Kitchen at 8 Main Street.
Second.
We have a motion by Bill and seconded by Arthur. Is there any comments or questions from the board?
Yeah, for those people that are watching and have questions, Bryantville Pizza Kitchen was formerly known as Billy Kids. We still, the old ones of us that grew up in Bryantville Center still call it Billy Kids, so now you have to forgive me for that.
Yeah. I'll take it. I'm okay with it.
Yeah, yeah. We come in as business anyway, right?
Yep. Yeah. That's what I know it as.
Yeah. Yeah.
So. I used to live right up over there when I first got married.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. That's
good
your
pizza.
Love.
Always good pizza there.
Your love of pizza.
Yeah. Good
pizza. We have a motion in front of us and a second. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none, your application as being approved.
Thank you.
Thank you very much
good
for
luck.
Coming in, and
yeah.
Good luck to you.
Thank you so much.
We'll stop by.
Yes, please do.
I'm going to move on to the board action items. We have a public hearing, but not until 7:30. So the next item under action is to consider the request of Chief Wall to appoint Plymouth County Deputy Sheriff James McDonald as a Pembroke Special Police Officer for the express and limited purpose of serving as Special Tactics Vehicle Operator on the Southeastern Massachusetts Law Enforcement Council team.
I move the appointment of James McDonald as recommended by Chief Richard Wall.
Second.
A motion by Arthur and seconded by Bill. Any questions or comments? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed? Hearing none, thank you.
Good guy.
The next action item is we have received an email from Rob Adams stating that he is resigning his position on the Herring Fisheries Commission effective immediately.
Mr. Chairman, move to accept the resignation with regret of Rob Adams of the Herring Fisheries Commission.
Second.
Thank you, Bill. Motion by Bill and second by Arthur. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, it's unanimous. The next item on our list is an email from the Commission on Disabilities, Chairman Tom Weinrich, on behalf of member Tom Wilkerson, stating that Mr. Wilkerson is resigning his position on the Commission of Disabilities effective immediately.
Mr. Chairman, I'd move to accept the resignation of Tom Wilkerson from the Commission on Disabilities with regret.
Second.
Motion by Bill, seconded by Arthur. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, it's unanimous. The next item that we have to deal with tonight is the application for a special use permit from the Bass Fishing Club Massachusetts Kayak Basin for their catch and release fishing tournament on Saturday, September 16th, 2017. The town beaches will be closed for the summer by that date. They still need approval from the Conservation Commission, who will impose their standard conditions. So our approval, should we vote for that approval, will be conditional. Are there any questions, or do I have a motion?
I don't have that in my packet. I'll move to grant a special use summer evening permit to Kenwood, Rhode Island, Massachusetts for the kayak bass fishing club to hold a fishing tournament on Oldham Pond on September 16th, conditionally upon the approval of the Conservation Commission.
Thank you, Bill. Is there a second?
What are the hours of the event?
6 a.m. to 3 p.m.
Yeah. That's when the fish come out, when the sun come up in the morning. Gotta get up early, I thought.
Yeah, but I'm not a fisherman, I guess.
We have a motion by Bill. Is
not
there a second?
Good one anyway.
Second.
Seconded by Dan. All those in favor of the conditional approval, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none.
That would be something Conservation would let us know that that's approved by them.
Can we deal with and have a motion on the minutes of the Selectmen's meeting of December 12th?
I'll move the minutes as written.
Second.
Motion by Arthur, second by Bill. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none, I deem it unanimous. The next item we have to deal with is on August 9th, 2016, Governor Baker signed an act to modernize municipal finance and government. Part of that was to amend Section 52 by inserting the fourth sentence as follows. The Board of Selectmen may designate any one of its members for the purpose of approving bills or payrolls under this section, provided, however, that the member shall make available to the board at its next meeting a record of such actions. This provision shall not limit the responsibility of each member of the board in the event of a non-compliance with this section. So, Bill, on December 20th, would you like to tell us what you signed?
Yes. I am pleased to report that on December 20th, 2016, I personally reviewed three accounts payable warrants totaling $444,531.54 and one payroll warrant totaling $271,073.27 prepared by the town accountant and authorized the itemized expenditures for payment.
Thank you, Bill.
That's signed by me.
Also, on December 27th, 2016, I am pleased to report that on that date, I personally reviewed 13 accounts payable warrants totaling $533,380.73 and two payroll warrants totaling $1,228,132.20 prepared by the town accountant and authorized the itemized expenditures for payment. Signed, Lewis W. Stone, Board of Selectmen's designee. Also, on January 3rd, 2017, I am pleased to report that on that date, I personally reviewed three accounts payable warrants totaling $1,198,635.89 and one payroll warrant totaling $201,199.92 prepared by the town accountant and authorized the itemized expenditures for payment. Signed, Lewis W. Stone. Let's see. The next item under old business was to be a report of a survey that was established by the Board of Selectmen, but the selectman that was going to make that report is not with us tonight. Matthew Furlong is out of the country, but he will return to take up the results of that survey to the board on January 23rd. We have a town administrator's report. Ed.
Mr. Chairman, a couple of items. Number one, last week we found out the passage of House Bill 4346, which deals with the Habermock sidewalk funding special act that was requested by the town to enable us to borrow in excess of about 20 years worth of payback for the Habermock Street sidewalk. So that being said, I know that the DPW director and the DPW commissioners now will go full speed ahead with the project, and I expect that bids or the construction actually will be started as soon as the weather permits. Correct, Ben?
Correct. That is correct.
That's great.
So that's we'll have a report for you shortly as to where we are and where we're headed in a timetable.
That's going to go right from the corner of Center Street up to the corner for the Learning Lane, is that?
That is correct. And it's all, the whole roadway has been prepared. If you recall back, I don't know, a couple of years ago, we actually shifted the roadway a little bit so that we could get by the pond coming down the hill.
Right.
And it's all prepared and ready to go.
Just for the public, the former speaker was Ben Bastinelli, DPW commissioner.
Thank you, Ben.
Ed?
Number two, another bit of good news we got on Friday. We received a notification from DEP that they have passed the, excuse me, the post-closure permit process to allow the town to begin construction of the solar array that's going to be on the capped landfill on Habermock Street. So we've been waiting on DEP to do that, and our thanks to TCR, the engineering firm for Onyx, the financier on the project, and Mike Delaney and Environmental Partners for doing a great job in assisting us in helping DEP with that process. So there's nothing now that stands in the way of that project being done, hopefully by May the 8th, which is the completion date for construction.
That good news. Great news. No.
Bill, you want to talk about today's little soiree at the Brockton Water Commission?
Well, several of us, Ed, myself, Lisa Cullity from the Board of Health, and Kathleen McCarthy from the Treasurer's Office, and Bob Clark from Conservation went up to Brockton and met with the Water Commissioners up there today, and we had was Attorney Amy
yeah, Kessel
from Coupland and Page, and we also had the firm
Blake Barton and Mel Huggins from Weston and Sampson.
From Weston and Sampson, the engineering firm that's doing the study currently now on Furnace Pond for the dredging project, and we advise them about what we're doing. We don't have any permits yet. There's permits haven't been filed yet. All the preliminary work is being done. And we met with them and advised them about what our intentions were. They were very receptive to us because it's going to make a cleaner, safer pond, better water for Brockton when they do get it. And there's be some work for all of us to work together on this project to hopefully get it completed sometime in the future. I was kind of surprised to learn that it's going to be a really long project when it does come out. But in a way, it's kind of good because it will be less money for us to do the project, and it won't be so much a year to get the project done. So we're kind of looking forward to see those facts and figures come out. But they were very receptive to us. I also brought up some other concerns to them about taking of the water from Furnace Pond, and we had some discussion about that, and a couple other things about the screening there is has been damaged, and the juvenile heron, some of them were getting into Silver Lake. And when we noticed that, we got a hold of Brian Creedon, and he immediately stopped the diversion until we corrected the problem, and we put up our own net down there to stop any of the juveniles from getting anywhere near it. So that was good. We also advised them about the increase of heron that we got this year, which was extremely high, and we had no way of getting the fish out this past fall because of the drought and because of less water in Furnace Pond. But we did manage to do that. We made a little stream over to the dam. We put some sandbags around the dam over there to keep the water level the same, and opened up a very small area for the juvenile fish to get through. And we actually had millions of juveniles going downstream this fall. So I don't think there's any way of counting them. There were so many that went down, but years past, there's been a count of 20,000 fish that have been coming up. Last year we had 120,000. This past year we had 238,000 when they pulled the counter, and we had another 50 or 60,000 that came up after they pulled the counter. So we're pretty close to 300,000 fish coming up last year. So if all of them dropped a half a million eggs or whatever, and that's an awful lot of fish going down. So we know that they won't all make it back here, but that's all part of the cycle. So we're very happy with that, and advise them that that's going to be part of our project also with the dredging of Furnace Pond. All of these entities and companies, commissions or whatever, all have to get on board, you know, DEP and the Division of Marine Fisheries and the Brockton and South Silver Lake. Everything is all going to have to work together to make this thing go. So it's in the works anyway. So
Mr. Chairman, as Bill was alluded to, the reason that the project is going to be expended over a long period of time is that there's only a couple windows of a 12-month cycle that you'll be able to dredge the pond. Obviously, wintertime is not going to be sufficient. In the spring passage and the fall passage of the herring is going to have to be addressed. So there's only going to be certain sections of the pond that are going to be dredged anyway. So it probably is going to be about a 3 or 4 or 5 months period during the course of 12 months that the pond's going to be able to be worked on. And that being said, and that means the folks that live in and around the pond that enjoy the pond, you know, won't be as hampered with their boating activities as one might think. So, and that was one of the things that we explained to the water commissioners today as well.
Yeah.
And this meeting was prompted by a request from DEP that we meet with the Brockton Water Commission to let them know about the project.
Yeah.
Very good.
I think it was, they were very receptive to us, so I thought that was great. So,
any other questions for Ed? Hearing none, we will move on to ask the selectmen. Does anyone have an item they'd like to discuss? I have one. Not Saturday's snowstorm, but the previous day, a call was made to the selectman's office from a resident with some questions about clearing our roads versus and comparing clearing our roads on that first snowstorm with the town of Hanson. So as you all know, I think you know, that the Board of Selectmen has no dealings with keeping our roads plowed. We have no authority there. We leave that to our elected commissioners and our very experienced director who has been doing this for years. So we don't intend to get involved with telling people how to plow the roads, but it is a question that came in, and this board has encouraged people to let the Board of Selectmen's office know if they have a question. So we will respond to the resident and give him the answer I hope that he was looking for. And having spoken about the snowstorms, I think we would have to bring up the Saturday storm. And I think we have to speak in a different way about how the town roads were kept clear and all of the many, many people that are involved in that, as well as the people that are plowing our roads. We have public safety people, etc. And from all that I know, they did an excellent job. We had a terrible storm with maybe up to 19 to 20 inches of snow, and a very unusual storm. And I think everyone did a wonderful job. I haven't heard any complaints from anybody. I don't know why I would. So thanks to the many people that were involved with keeping everybody safe in the town.
I have to agree with that. I think they did a great job.
Yes, certainly.
Ben, correct me if I'm wrong. We've got about 120 miles of streets. About 120 miles of streets in town. Is that pretty accurate?
That is correct.
So
yes, sir.
To have a problem here or there would not be unusual.
We had our share during the storm. We not our town equipment, but some of our hired equipment that we depend on, and for the most part, usually is very reputable and dependable. We had some breakdowns, especially in the West Elm Street area and out towards the Hanover line, and we had a little bit of difficulty keeping up to keep those roads sufficiently bare and pick up the slack for the lack of the equipment in that area, but, you know, I think as Selectman Stone said, for the most part, it was a successful operation.
Yeah, I don't want to discourage people from calling us, because if they have a problem like Selectman, is to let us know so we can let the DPW know, or call the DPW directly, but...
Absolutely. I mean, sometimes, you know, we, for the most part, we're going to find out, but we might not know as quickly if people don't let us know that they see something, or that something doesn't seem quite right in their neighborhood. I mean, that, you know, I would encourage them to let us know so that we can keep up.
Thank you.
The Selectmen received this evening some information regarding the MMA annual business meeting, which will be held Saturday, the 21st of January, at the Heinz Convention Center from 10:15 to 11:45 a.m. And we would need to let these folks know if any of our board members or officials in the town would like to attend this. There's also some rooms available at the Sheraton, which you can make a reservation. They are holding a certain number of rooms. So if the any of the board members are planning on attending, I believe we have to let the folks know by Friday, the 13th of January.
I think I'd probably like to go to that. You got a lot of, you going up this year?
Yeah, I'm registered already as well, for the Sheraton.
Excellent.
For the event.
Yeah, no, I'm not interested
in
Sheraton, but...
I'll drive from Pembroke.
We'll, if you want, I'll go up with you. Or you can,
that'd be great.
Yeah. There's a lot of good information up there that that's available to the town, and we're not going to know about it unless we go and take a look and see what they have, so... Definitely go with that.
That's great.
Okay.
I think we can squeeze one more issue in before 7:30 when we have a public hearing. Under upcoming issues on January 23rd, the chairman's review of minutes and agenda posting to the town's website. And at 7 p.m. on the 23rd, we will have Dave Shea from the Pembroke Chamber of Commerce speak to us, and also on the 23rd, a request for an appointment to the Recreation Commission, and on February 13th, Jennifer Mathias will come to give us an update on her property and the Hill Bog project. So those are upcoming issues. Now at
I have one quick thing.
Yes, but, Bill.
If you got a minute before we go into the, I noticed that some of the ponds have frozen over, and every year I say the same thing, try to say it at the selectmen's meetings. We've already had with a death up in Maine where somebody went through the pond up there on a snowmobile. We've had some other kids have gone through the ice in different places. I live right on Furnace Pond, and the ice is open one day, it's closed the next day, it's open 2 days later, it's closed. It's like the ice is not safe, and really people should, you know, heed the warning about their children and keep them off of the ice, and also their animals, any dogs or anything like that, because it's only puts the firefighters at risk to try to get out there and get somebody's dog or whatever. So if you can just you know, cognizance for the rest of the winter. Keep your eyes and ears open for your kids and your animals. So.
Good. Thank you, Bill. It's 7:30, and it's time for our public hearing. The Pembroke Board of Selectmen will hold a public hearing on Monday, January 9th, 2017, at 7:30 p.m. in Veterans Hall, 100 Center Street, Pembroke, on the application for a new Class II used car dealer's license at 328 Mattakeesett Street, Pembroke, to be held in the name of Rotary Auto Repair, Inc., doing business as Rotary Auto Repair. The premises described as a two-bay garage with an attached office and 1,500 square feet of paved land for parking and the display of automobiles at the intersection of Mattakeeson and McGowan Streets, Route 14. Restrictions: not more than 5 vehicles in serviceable condition for sale are to be on the lot at one time. So this evening we have Ben Bastinelli of Rotary Auto Repair, Inc., who is the applicant.
How are you?
We're fine.
So basically, I opened up a service and repair shop. It was formerly where Auto Works was. I'm sure you're all probably familiar with it.
Yep. Ken could fix anything.
Huh?
Ken could fix
anything.
Yeah,
he's a great guy, yeah. So I wanted to be able to sell cars there like it was used for in the past. As I've been told, it had a 5-car license, so I was asking for the same amount. And you know, I'm familiar with the process. I have a used car license at another location I've had for 6 years, so I'm pretty familiar with how it all works, and I was hoping I could continue what I was doing and be able to sell cars down there.
I just got one question for you. How come you didn't call it Roundabout?
A couple people asked me that. I don't know.
Good name.
I'd just like to make one other statement here on the information we have.
Sure.
Is that the applicant has satisfied the CORI requirements, and all bills associated with this property have been paid in full.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
If nobody's got any other questions, I'll move that we grant this. I mean, we know Ben. He's been in business in town for a number of years. His father has been involved for a number of years. There's no question about his reputation, and I think if he thinks he can sell 5 cars and move 5 used cars through there on a pretty regular basis, good luck to him. I think he's taken on a big set of shoes to fill. As I say, Ken Wisemuth could fix anything, whether it was a snowblower or a car or a truck or whatever, so you did big shoes to fill, but yeah. I'm sure you'll be equal to it.
Thank you.
One second.
Okay, there's a motion by Arthur and a second by Bill to grant the license. Any other questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none, I deem it unanimous.
Thank you.
Thank you, and good luck to you.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah,
good luck.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Okay.
Okay, Ben. Mr. Thorne, do we have the need for an executive session this evening?
Yes, we do.
Yes, you do. Okay. Can I have a motion, please?
Mr. Chairman,
Bill.
Move to go into executive session under Mass General Laws, Chapter 38, Section 21, to discuss strategy with respect to collective bargaining or litigation. If an open meeting may have a detrimental effect on the bargaining or litigation position of the public body, and the chair so declares. Clerical, DPW, police, fire unions, police union, MOA amendment. And 7, to comply with or act under the authority of Mass General Laws 41-111F for the police department.
And the chair does declare. Motion by Bill, is there a second?
Second.
Second by Arthur. All those in favor, Dan?
Yes.
Bill?
Yes.
Arthur?
Yes.
And I vote yes. Mr. Thorne, is there any need to reconvene the public session? Will there be any votes taken, needed?
I'm going to ask town council if the MOA has to be voted on in open session or closed session.
I believe you actually, I must have mistaken, I thought you had already voted it, just need to be signed. Right, has that... It has not. Okay. Then you can discuss that as well. Have you put police down as one of your...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So if that means we will come out in order to sign that?
Yes.
Yeah.
We will.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we will reconvene this public session at the end of the executive session. So... we have taken the vote, and the next regular scheduled meeting of the Pembroke Board of Selectmen will be held on January 23rd. There will be no meeting next week, as it is Martin Luther King Day. And Town Hall will also be closed on that Monday, the 16th. Thank you, and we'll be back later.